Freely is not too happy in the midst of this I am no longer vegan drama that has just been growing and growing recently.
Okay, so let me start by saying I know every one of these well-known YouTubers making these why I'm no longer vegan videos. Some of them I know very well, have hung out a lot, and I like them as people. Not that they would ever publicly support me or anything like that, but still. This is a video for anyone out there who's ever made one of these why I'm no longer vegan videos. So I've been in this movement for over 12 years. I've seen people come and go. I've heard every excuse there is. And I'm sick of it. I'm sick to fucking death of hearing these bullshit excuses to end animals' lives again. From brain fog and pimples and gas to my baby took all my protein. Get the fuck out of here. There is no scientifically sound evidence to support you going back to eating animals and their byproducts. So don't even try and fucking use that as a reason. Stop looking to blame everything and everyone around you for your own fucking failure. Stop. Take responsibility. You know, all I hear is this me, 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 me. What about the someone who now has to suffer as a result of your choices? You know, I could spend all day debunking every one of these pathetic excuses, but all I really need to say is the animals don't need your excuses. They are not your fucking dinner. They are not a lifeless product to increase your protein levels. They are a living being like you and me, worthy of life. They are here existing on this earth for their own purpose.
She has a bullying attitude, puts other people down, yet looks like she is wasting away herself. She's completely disconnected from reality, let alone nature, and is starting to look like a man, probably because of the lack of nutrients in her pure sugar diet. Her logic is recycled garbage that is regurgitated over and over again by pretty much every vegan on the planet and has been for the past, I don't know, 10 years or so. The way that these vegans act in response to these I am no longer vegan videos just reinforces the religious and cult-like behavior of this movement. Instead of acknowledging or considering that, hey, maybe this diet doesn't work for everyone, that that's even a possibility, showing any sort of objective thinking or open-mindedness, it makes it very clear that their true intention is based on the misconceptions they have about animal cruelty.
And let's get this straight. If you make a video why I am no longer vegan, you were never actually vegan to begin with. So remove the word vegan from the title and replace it with plant-based. Because what you're doing now is exploiting, misrepresenting, confusing the whole movement to the public just for your own selfish benefits. You were not vegan. Because actual vegans would never contemplate going back to paying for the abuse, torture, and slaughter of their friends. Never, never, never. But of course, those making these videos won't remove the word vegan from the video title because they're actually monetizing these videos, essentially making blood money.
Sweetie, you can't have it both ways. Although, I know plenty of girls who like it two ways. Complaining about people making money when you're doing the same thing yourself, except you're poisoning people with your advice. It's okay to harm other humans, but it's not okay for them to monetize their video explaining about the issues they had with the diet and how they fixed it. It's very clear that Freely has created this illusion and has her own perception that is very out of touch with logic and reason.
You know full well making these sort of videos leads to more pain, suffering, torture for innocent animals around the world because your followers just follow your lead and these videos go viral. You know, and they get a lot of attention, they get a lot of shares and likes and all that sort of shit because we have these people who are uneducated, plant-based eaters supporting this sort of cruelty. Just ignorantly supporting this sort of cruelty. And on the other side, we are surrounded by a society who has this sick flesh fetish. We are still living in this society dominated by these people who don't give a fuck about animals and they celebrate when vegans go back to eating animals. People who actually give a fuck about animals do not give up on them. They do not throw them in a stir fry when they feel hungry or gassy or get a pimply face. They take responsibility and they do not stop until they find a cruelty-free answer to the issues.
It's very obvious that she cares about the image of the vegan diet and that is her only priority. For her to think that these people were never vegan and that they were literally waiting for an opportunity to consume rotten animal flesh is completely insane, considering the trial and error and how much these people try to stick to a vegan diet. This ties into the, oh, vegans always do the diet wrong if they fail. It's completely crazy. I don't know what her understanding of cruelty is, but there's no diet that is animal cruelty free. Just because you aren't directly eating the animal or stepping on the bug in your apartment does not mean that it's not getting harmed or the animals aren't getting displaced. Commercial agriculture, spraying pesticides, monocropping, there's many negative things that happen from the displacement of all of these animals to grinding up of rabbits and baby deer in the harvesters, killing millions and millions of insects, exploitation of bees. There's many negative aspects of commercial farming that are used to give you that fruit, that plate of cereal, whether it's those animals being ground up in the combine or whether slave labor is being used to pick your avocados. There is some degree of cruelty being used in your diet unless you are supporting sustainable agriculture. I care about animals. I actually understand ecosystems, and it takes life to give life. Vegans choose to live in this fairy tale land. They want to stay disconnected with nature, go to Whole Foods, go to these markets, buying fruits out of season, mutant vegetables, whatever it may be, to make themselves feel better because they are not directly involved in the killing of, well, what they consider animal life. To them, it's okay for humans and animals to suffer as long as they are not present and acknowledging it. Maybe if vegans showed some compassion for their own race, they would be a little more successful with their movement. Animals are meant to eat other living beings. We are so disconnected with nature and what it takes to survive that we are considering a vital part of our history being the consumption of animal foods to not be something we should be doing anymore. Losing this part of human primal instinct is only something that we are able to see in the context of modern society.
They do whatever it fucking takes to heal. And actual vegans know that eating corpse does not heal. It does the opposite. You know, it will not heal your gut after fucking up and taking antibiotics. It will not give you amazing skin, energy levels, or digestion. It will not make you more spiritual. We know this.
We know this? No, we actually know the opposite. Animal foods do heal your gut. They do clear up your skin. They do give you energy levels. Vegans are frightened of people knowing that they feel better consuming animal foods. People have tried every single version of vegan diets to failure, and then they miraculously feel better after one meal or a matter of days of consuming animal foods. They suddenly become healthy, get their vitality back from these animal foods, but referring to animal foods as dead corpses is supposed to make them bad for you? There has never been a group of people that has subsisted off of a vegan diet in history. Every single indigenous group has consumed approximately 65% of their calories from animal foods as a minimum. The presence of these animal nutrients in the form of fat-soluble vitamins has been present for all of human history, except for the vegan diet. This witch is so confident with her dangerous advice while she is probably shitting her brains out on some crickets in the woods every hour and a half.
And there is a common theme throughout these videos, this obsession with hens' periods, aka eggs. I mean, the irony is that eggs are so fucking unhealthy that you literally cannot even state on packaging in the USA, for instance, that they are healthy. You cannot say that. It's illegal. You can't say they're healthful. You can't even say they contribute healthful components. You know why? Because it has been shown time and time again that they are little acid balls of cruelty. You know, you can't even say that they are a good source of protein because they're not.
The reason that you can't label eggs as healthy has a lot to do with low cholesterol propaganda. Ironically, eggs contain all of the nutrients missing on your vegan diet. They aren't good sources of protein. They're little acid balls of cruelty. Vegans tend to demonize animal products with these words, thinking it does something. Almost every major health organization has acknowledged that dietary cholesterol is not correlated with serum cholesterol, as the body adjusts to demands regardless of the diet. And when you look at the nutrient profile of eggs and how they literally contain every single vitamin, mineral, and element your body needs, it becomes very clear that there is a lack of understanding of nutrition in general, let alone people on the vegan diet that might have a bias towards not consuming animal products.
But I digress. You know, this is like an irrelevant side point to the fact that the egg industry is a fucking torture train for billions and billions of baby chicks and chickens around the world every year. Do some research, educate yourself, and you'll never eat them again.
When vegans tell you to do your own research, what they actually mean is go look at Dr. Greger and Dr. McDougall and ignore any non-vegan research. Because if you actually did your own research, you wouldn't be following a vegan diet. And in this specific case, if she researched eggs, she would have found out how nutrient-dense they were. Vegans are so out of touch with nature, they never acknowledge the idea of sustainable, cruelty-free, pasture-raised animals. When I go to the farmer's market later and buy eggs from pastured sustainable chickens living in a natural ecosystem, vegans have very little to say about it, especially considering they need 15 ingredients shipped from all around the world in plastic packaging to make a fake egg.
So, another thing I've noticed is this theme with fish throughout these videos. Suddenly, fish aren't fucking animals. Fish aren't meat, and it's okay to eat them. Why? Because they swim in the water? Like, what is the what? You know, they have hearts. They have faces. They have eyes. They have a nervous system. They feel fucking pain. They are animals. You know, you are behaving unethically if you eat the flesh of sea life. Don't lie to yourself. Fish are a someone and they belong in our hearts, not in our stomachs.
From an ethical standpoint, for instance, certain mollusks are found to be deemed adequate for a vegan diet based on their central nervous system, seeing that they don't feel pain. But vegans usually deny this idea. This ties back to being out of touch with nature and being concerned about not physically putting a piece of animal flesh in their mouth. They have no problem with that farmer grinding up rats in their wheat cereal in the morning, as long as they are not directly involved in the process. Same thing with the plant-based burgers. There's a big push against fake meat from the vegan movement, despite it being cruelty-free, supposedly. These people have created their own perception, their own illusion, and there really is no pleasing them. It's completely crazy.
And then I see some of these people go and sneakily delete these peace-promoting, ethical, vegan videos they made in the past. And I'm like, what the actual fuck? So you don't want people to actually know that you gave a fuck about animals at one stage? You don't want to help others make the connection, make this world a better place? You don't want others to know you felt fucking fabulous living a certain way? You know, did you lie then? Are you lying now? I find this behavior really untrustworthy. I cannot trust these people. And it just makes this whole charade about their ego and not about the animals. The simple fact is, if you eat animals, you are pro-animal cruelty. That is it. How can you be anything else? Animals are our friends and we do not eat our friends. Full stop, end of discussion.
Trustworthy? Vegans are the least trustworthy people, as they will say anything to promote their way of life. These people that are no longer vegan realize that they were tricked into this cult and that animals are essential for human health. Saying that animals are your friends and you shouldn't eat your friends, first thing that friend will do in nature when it's hungry is eat your face off because it still has its natural survival instinct. Being out of touch with nature, what it takes to procure calories, is the primary issue with vegans. These animals are not innocent. The world is a very cruel place, and any source of calories is fair game in that environment.
And this is all before we address the environment that you are now fucking up. Animals want to live somewhere. I want to live somewhere. Humans need to live somewhere. Your diet, your cruel, destructive diet, is eating the rainforest. It's eating the habitat, so we have nowhere to fucking live eventually. Educate yourself.
What about the environment are we exactly fucking up? The greenhouse gas emissions from animal agriculture are less than 5%. This is a drop of water in the bucket compared to other issues. From the fact that climate change is a normal part of the Earth's processes, and that other sources of CO2 emissions, such as having children or driving cars, make much more of an impact than going on a plant-based diet. And we didn't even touch on how corporations produce most of the greenhouse gas emissions, how several of the largest cargo ships produce more CO2 than every single car on the road. People really like to misinterpret ideas and push agendas without looking at data.
Anyway, that is my video. If you think it's mean and savage, I don't give a fuck, okay? What's mean and savage is paying someone to slaughter our friend for a meal. I care about what is truly important, and that's saving the lives of innocent animals. Not sending them to slaughter because you have some pimples and you have gut issues or you have whatever. I don't care what your problem is. There is always, always a vegan solution. And you are just lying to yourself and making up excuses, trying to say there isn't. You've been debunked many, many times. Don't give me a pity story when your pity story ends the lives of animals. If you think your situation is bad, think about being the one who is watching friends and family members be slaughtered in front of them and waiting for their turn. The flesh you have on your plate is the dead body of someone who wanted to live. Let that sink in. And lastly, we need to counteract these "why I am no longer vegan" videos with videos from those of you who are actually vegan, who are vegan for life. Why I am still vegan. You know, make videos with that title or counteract these videos, because it is not okay. Don't make light of this situation. Animals' lives are involved. This is fucking serious. And I'd like to, you know, pass the mic to, say, Rora Lyman and Supreme Banana. Tell us why you are still vegan and why you're going to be vegan for life. That would be fucking awesome. I'll see you soon.
This video that she made is not mean or savage whatsoever. It's unintelligent, fear-mongering, face value bullshit. I don't know what is going on in her head that she thinks there is a solution to all of these plant-based dieters that have literally tried everything, but they really need to stop saying that there are hypothetical solutions when people have literally tried every single possible version of a vegan diet. I made this analogy in my other video. If you pour regular gasoline, premium gasoline, super gasoline on a fire and they all make the fire worse, are you going to pour the ultra gasoline on the fire or are you going to pour water on the fire? The vegans are going to pour the ultra gasoline on the fire, and the person that snaps out of it is going to pour the water on the fire. She truly does not care about people. I'm surprised vegans are so caring about animals and lack compassion just in their lives for other things. I really just have a hard time putting the whole thing together, because we know from a health perspective, a vegan diet is not ideal. We know from an environmental perspective that we are being lied to about how much of an impact going plant-based actually is. And from the moral or ethical perspective, there is definitely some fogginess between commercial agriculture being used to harvest plant products and sourcing animal foods from local, sustainable, cruelty-free sources. So thank you guys for watching. If you guys would like to support the channel, please subscribe and share the video. I will put a bunch of recommended videos at the end of this in regards to vegan versus carnivore nutrients, in regards to debunking vegan 2018, if you guys want to look into this further. In the comments, I just have a bunch of stuff from my Amazon shop to my Patreon, social media pages. If you guys would like to reach out to me for one-on-one consultations, any of you ex-vegans or soon-to-be ex-vegans out there need help incorporating animal foods into your diet, feel free to shoot me an email, frankatufano@gmail.com or reach out to me through the contact form on my website.